So guys, the stunts keep getting bigger, the bangs keep getting bigger. Is that what this franchise is all about when you look at sort of other big summer releases, Transformers, Planet of the Apes? This has a very certain feel to it, doesn't it?
Yes, but I've also fallen into that trap, and maybe Jason has too, that sometimes you get more, as you quote, bang for your buck, but there's no story. The story suffers for the explosiveness and the more visual content, and you lose the heart. I think this one has a bit more soulful feelings. I think the conversations between myself and Jason have a bit more it's more grounded, a little more soul. So you get, in other words, I think it went up in all areas, and that's the hard part, is to keep that balance going.
Because there's a proper bromance between your two characters. A lot of fist bumping going on, Jason.
Yeah, we don't like to wash our hands.
There we go. Bringing me back to the movie. But it's serious stuff, Jason, because you cheated death, right?
Well, filming it, yeah. We had a little mishap where the brakes failed.
It wasn't a little, it was a major mishap.
Bottom of the Black Sea, yeah.
It's, you know what's amazing? It's when we do all these stunts, right? The explosion, whatever. And then you see a real accident. It's a whole other vibe, man. You know what I mean?
He's a proper tough guy, though, wasn't he? It's like, bit of an accident, bottom of the Black Sea.
This is no BS. Because of his aquatic skills, he's the only one who would have made it. None of us can swim that well. We're all heavy, loaded down with a lot of weaponry and thick, heavy boots. Wouldn't have been... And it was pitch black where he was. You know what I'm saying? The Black Sea is black. Am I right? Oh, it's a swimming pool. Let me go up there. It's black.
But when you're at the bottom there, Jason, what was going through your head? Was it simply survival?
Yeah, because it's, you go through mixed emotions. You know, you think you're going to die, and then you're trying to rescue yourself. It's a very harrowing.
I never asked you when the truck went down. It went nose first. Did it ever tip, or did it stay nose down?
Well, you don't actually feel what's happening with the truck, because you float in the water. Mm-hmm. So you don't know what's happening. You're just feeling for the gaps, how to get out. Yeah.
Proper tough guy, you see.
I'm telling you, man. It was like no joke.
You bring in the kids in this movie. Was that adding that extra dimension as well? Because your character becomes almost a father.
We've gone around enough. We've had our situations. Then we bring in the new ones, and as with youth must be served, but they also make mistakes. So now I have to come back and bring out the real deal to save the youth, and then the youth in the end prevails and makes a good accounting of themselves. So it becomes like a father, son, family, okay. And every generation thinks they're tougher, and then when they go and get stuff, they need help from the parents.
I mean, the cast just keeps on getting bigger and bigger. I mean, when you look at that poster behind you, I mean, you're going to need a billboard for Expendables.
Well, actually, we're thinking about doing it on the back.
Yeah.
We'll just keep growing. We get the first flipping poster.
Is there one that got away every time that you want for the next one?
The guy?
Yeah.
A person? Yeah, it would always be like Clint. You know, that would be great, just to top it out, say Clint. Even if it's for 1 month, he plays the president. Just one scene. That would kind of set it off.
Clint?
He gets more of Clint Eastwood, yeah.
Does he?
He does,
good
yeah.
for you.